you probably don't need Consumer Reports to tell you if you're going to go out and buy a Jaguar F-Type. I mean, just look at it. And listen. I mean, this F-Type is just, it's a chatty catty. I mean, it roars when you start up. It roars when you step on it. And then you get off the throttle. Listen to that. Pop, pop, pop. It's fantastic. Look, if you think Jaguar means traditional British restraint, not here. This Atomic Pumpkins, its whole job is to get noticed. This is an F-Type S, the hottest version. It packs a 5-liter supercharged V8 that belts out 495 horsepower. Go, Jaguar! Driving the F-Type, there's no question this is an athletic car. It's got great reflexes. It's not quite as engaging as a Porsche Cayman or a Boxster. Feels more like a British Corvette. Man, I'm not saying that's a bad thing. Not at all. In fact, you get the F-Type out on a track and turn off the stability control. This thing is a drift king. Plenty of oversteer on demand. Gotta say, the whole thing is kind of like Fast and the Furious, Downton Abbey style. When you're not driving it like you stole it, or like a press car, the car lives up to the Jaguar's tradition of grace with pace. It's got a ride that doesn't beat you up. This F-Type's a convertible. A coupe comes later. Now, don't dismiss the convertible because it has a soft top instead of the more trendy, fancy-dancy hard top. This roof works quick, and the cabin stays warm and quiet inside. The cabin has good room for two. Front seats are generous and supportive. Everything is stitched, even around the roof header. Fancy. The controls aren't exactly intuitive, but there are some cool touches here. This car begs for long road trips, but you better pack light because there just isn't much trunk space. But look, if you buy a car like this, you better forget about practicality or the price tag. Car we're driving here, stickers for over $100,000. Look, you spend the money on this Jag because you want it. I've got to admit, I kind of want one. I'd have to win it on the prices right in order to afford it though. Still, what makes this car desirable? It's something different. It's not a Corvette, it's not a Porsche, it's not a Mercedes-Benz, and it's not bound by tradition like other Jaguars have been. To me, that makes this car even more desirable. Check out our ratings of sports cars at consumerreports.org.